Hey guys, and welcome back to the School Finesse Podcast. I'm your host, Eamon. Today I just have an announcement, or maybe it's a tip, probably a suggestion. It's very simple. Here it is. Sometimes you just have to congratulate yourself. I was thinking about this earlier, and I'm like, man, so often we applaud and praise other people for their great works and accomplishments, but never do the same for ourselves. It's like we wait for someone else to do it for us. Have you ever thought about that? Well, in today's episode, we'll talk more about self-applause, and then in our news fix, I'll tell you about some students who lost $50 million because they did not fill out the FAFSA, the Free Application for Federal Student Aid. Before we go on, we have the word of the week, which is the opposite of last week's word. Here it is. Mellifluous. M-E-L-L-I-F-L-U-O-U-S. Sweet or musical, pleasant to hear. All right, enough of that mellifluous music and back to our regularly scheduled tune. So today we're talking about congratulating yourself. I mean, sometimes you just have to tell yourself, man, I'm doing a good job. Now, some people will interpret that to mean you're being arrogant or selfish, but no, you're raising your own self-esteem. Don't rely on someone else to notice or recognize you before you finally realize that you're doing a good job. Not many people are going to notice your smaller successes, but that's fine. You know, many of those people are waiting for the graduation ceremony, the completion of the self-help program, the new car, the new home, the new whatever. But they don't recognize all your steps to get there. Your successful group presentation, your completion of a class, your financial milestone of paying off some of your debt, your new habit, your changed attitude. Those are all personal achievements that you notice before anyone else, if they even realize it. I like what Julie, a woman with passion for health and wellness, said in her Making Mindfulness blog. She says, take a moment to think about what you say to those around you when they're doing well. Perhaps you demonstrate your feelings through everyday gestures, but at the very least, you use thoughtful, positive, and uplifting words. She adds, now think about the last time you've done that for yourself. Can you remember the last time you worked hard to make a change and actually gave yourself credit? Do you encourage, uplift, congratulate, give thanks to yourself for your own accomplishments? She reminds us, congratulating yourself on your progress isn't conceited or arrogant. It helps you express your self-love and allows you to acknowledge the hard work you've put into various aspects of your life. She ends on this note. Take a few minutes to reflect on how far you've come and how well you're doing. You deserve to be congratulated. You can learn more on this topic and others on Julie's Making Mindfulness blog post. It's called Congratulate Yourself. I hope this insight here encourages you to give yourself a verbal stamp of approval for every baby step or giant leap to your next goal. Make it a habit. Congratulate yourself. Up next, we have our news fix about the $50 million FAFSA neglect. But first, here's a challenge for the week. It's simple. Don't be selfish. Share this podcast link with a friend so they can be encouraged just as much as you are. All right, on to the news fix. So last week, Monday, the 2019-2020 Free Application for Federal Student Aid, FAFSA, opened. While many students hurry to fill out their forms in anticipation for some type of aid, others will wait until the last minute. Here's what happened a couple years ago. 32,899 Colorado students did not complete the FAFSA, and over 40% of them could have been awarded thousands of dollars in grants, funds, and scholarships to use for college. Don't make the same mistake these Colorado students made. Here are four tips of advice from some financial aid and scholarship staff. Number one, the early bird gets the financial aid. Two, always be prepared. Three, be thorough. And four, don't get discouraged. You can find out more about completing your financial aid and scholarship forms on studentaid.ed.gov. A link to this news article titled, this is a long one, Colorado students missed out on $50 million in federal financial aid because they didn't fill out the forms. Here's what you need to know about FAFSA. Along with the link to Julie's Making Mindfulness blog post, Congratulate Yourself, will be in our YouTube description box when you search School Finesse. Be sure to comment, like, subscribe, and share with a friend who you want to succeed. Always remember, tune in every Monday morning for a new tip on how you can finesse your way through school. I'm your host, Amen, signing off.